This program is presented for your enjoyment by Uncle Toby's, the makers of Uncle Toby's Oats, Natural Muesli and Muesli Bars.
In the distance you can hear the sound of a cheer and the laugh and the roar of a crowd.
And you can feel the expectation and the wild jubilation as they're shouting the winner's names aloud.
'Cause it's the greatest game in town.
And it's the craziest fun around.
It's a knockout.
That's the name.
It's a knockout.
That's the game.
It's a knockout.
That's the name of the game.
Four teams get a second chance to win $1,000 in tonight's Prepper Charge Heat. Here's the first of two teams playing for the Premier State, led by Don Pardy and with plenty to prove tonight in the red for New South Wales Cup, the MacArthur Shearers. Determined not to miss out for a second time, Captain Roger Hall is looking for an improved showing from the side in blue for Victoria, the Western Port Warriors. Making up a twin attack for their state and hoping to stage a big form reversal is the team led by Robert Jackson in yellow for New South Wales, the Southern Highlanders. Pulling out all the stops to achieve our first win comes the team captained by Graham Mufflin in the green of South Australia, the Adelaide Ramblers. Now welcome your hosts for a tough night of great games on It's a Knockout, Billy J. Smith and Fiona McDonald.
He's all racked up, ready for the cold tonight, the boy.
Hello, everybody. Nice to see you. We've really lashed out this week. We bought Combat a new jacket. Come and sit down for a minute with us. Come on, sit. I've trained him. Sit. Sit. Stand. Good, see?
Very well done. Very well done.
Okay, off you go. Check out the teams. Thank you.
All right, we're going a little bit nautical tonight.
Yeah.
I'm a rear admiral, actually. Medals and all. Good conduct badge, the whole lot.
Yeah, I think I rank higher than you.
Oh, I don't know about that one. All right, we have four teams that were unplaced in their first heat, so they'll be looking for a little bit of improvement tonight.
They will be, and the standard gets higher. Last week, the Coorong Castaways from South Australia set a new scoring record.
They won
five events, and they took second place in two of them for a massive 24 points. And the scoring, I hope, will be as good tonight, Billy.
Certainly hope so.
Let's run through our teams for you. The Shearers in red for New South Wales. We have the Warriors in blue for Victoria. Also for New South Wales, we have the Highlanders in yellow and a cheer for the Ramblers in green for South Australia.
Righto, there are teams. The man that's going to look after the teams is a guy who really gets into the spirit of things if it's a knockout.
Let's boogie!
Righto, let's bring him on in. Here's Ricky May.
Hey! Hi, Ricky.
How are you, man? Oh, I see, you're piping us on board, eh?
Piping you on. How are you?
John.
Great to be back.
Oh, terrific.
Real great
terrific.
To see you, Fiona.
Yeah. Got some good games tonight, too.
Oh, my favourite tonight, Choo 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 Boogie. Woo-hoo! Wait till you see this one.
You'll love
Listen,
it.
You got to excuse me, I've got to mince up my whistle and...
We'll find a hooter for
fix
you.
I'll be back.
All right, well, Ricky's getting over there with Eldon Chondell. Let's tell everyone about our first game tonight.
Okay, opening game is called Spin Out, and it features a guy and girl from each team in a hazardous trip down the big pool in a barrel.
All right, here's heat number one coming up, and your starter is Ricky May.
I got it working. On your spin, set.
And heat number one sees the Reds and the Blues in action here. The Reds, of course, are the MacArthur Shearers from New South Wales. The Blue are from Victoria. They're the Western Warriors.
And in the blue, we have Peter Alexander, who's a technical services officer, done a bit of rope climbing. And his assistant is Sue Astfolk, who's a trainee mother partner. She's done a bit of basketball. I don't know if that'll help her. In the red, we have Dave Wilson, who's a factory manager who plays golf.
He's a factory manager for Shirley's Fertilizer.
Ah, and Carolyn Knight, who's an aerobics instructor, and she's doing some hefty paddling there.
As you see, the girls do the paddling around, and the guys pull the rope, so they work their way up the pool, and the first team home will be the winner. They'll go into the final. Not much between them at this stage.
Certainly.
Maybe the Reds just a little bit in front.
It's a very dizzying game, this one.
Yes, I don't think you want to have a night out before you get into this one. So the Reds just ahead of the Blues. They're trying desperately at this stage, the Blues.
Oh, something's happened to the Blues. They're not paddling properly.
They're not getting around. They're not going around at all. like the Reds are going to get home there. They're turning their way to the end, and they have made it. All right, everybody, check out the Ricky. Any problems here, my boy?
No, the only problems were for the Blue. I think we struck a little seasickness three quarters of the way down. It's a win for the Reds.
All right, they make it to our final.
So, we'll join them in the final, the yellow team or the green team? Let's find out, Ricky.
Cement mix is ready, rope steady.
All right, the yellows are from New South Wales, they're the Southern Highlanders, and in the green, South Australia's representative, the Adelaide Ramblers.
And for the South Australian team, we have Mick Madigan, who is a spud merchant. He sells tatties and plays basketball. He's joined by Carmel Tooth, who's a bank clerk, who does a few gym workouts, which might help her.
All right, having a look at the yellow team, we have Wayne Fanning in there. He just about lost his hat.
He's a teacher at Braidwood and teaches maths.
And Donata Page, is there? She's a pretty good athlete a few years back.
Yeah, she's a partner in her husband's fertiliser business.
Oh, my goodness, there's a lot of fertiliser around in here tonight. No further comment needed. Here's the Greens out in front of this stage, doing it pretty well. Yellow coming along fairly solidly, though. Spinning their way up the pool here. The game has spun out. The winner will go into the final.
Wayne seems to have that rope pulling down fairly well here. Oh, we're going around for another spin.
Course, but it is the green team from South Australia out in front at the Oh, the yellows are nearly gone.
A bit of balancing work from Donata there. Here comes South Australia down to the end.
So the green spinning away towards a place in the final. And an effort, 2 points. The yellows in a bit of trouble, I think they've hit a submerged log. The green team are home, and check out and see if there's any problems with the big boy.
Poor old New South Wales, Billy, but here come the Green. Congratulations, they're in the final. Green.
All right, so there they go.
Australia!
Stand by for the Reds and the Greens, and here's our starter, Ricky May.
And...
they're on their way. 4 points for the winner, 2 for the runner-up. The Reds from New South Wales and the Greens from South Australia. Who will get the first points of the night? First biggies, anyway.
In the red for New South Wales, the Shearers, we have Dave Wilson, the factory manager, and Carolyn Knight, the aerobics instructor.
Over there for the Greens, it's Mick Madigan and Carmel Tooth. Wow, they're really spinning around, two of those South Australians.
The Green team just at the edge at the moment, but New South Wales aren't too far behind.
Have a look at the face over here on Dave Wilson.
Amazing expression on Dave.
Dave has a very strange look on the face.
It's called true grit. Determination.
Tell you what, it's working too, because he's moved up into second spot at the moment.
And he's overtaking very smartly too.
He's moved just out in front of the Greens. So it's going to be a nice tight finish here. Whoa, the Greens nearly losing the whole thing there. But the red of New South Wales just in front. Green of South Australia not far behind them now. Final of our opening event tonight, and it's a knockout. And New South Wales get through and do it. They're on their way to it. Round they go, and up they go, and over
New
they
South
go. Better check it out, though, with Ricky May. Make sure everything's right, was it?
Yeah, everything's dead set right. We got a win for the Red. New South Wales, Billy.
So it's a great start for New South Wales. I'm sure they're happy. Let's find out now with Fiona.
And muscles must be exhausted.
Yeah.
Oh, that was great. You've got the first 4 points.
Yeah, Ricky.
Billy, let's put them up on the board.
Well, what I'll do first up is put 2-1-2 there for South Australia and 4 for New South Wales. And that's the opening points for the night. Well, our teams roll along the Cactus Course in tumbling tumbleweeds. You'll see that next game when we return after the break right here on It's a Knockout.
It's a Knockout, that's the name of the game.
We don't have any up there at this stage for the Yellows or the Blues, but we do have 2 for South Australia, the Ramblers, and our leaders after event number 1 are the Shearers from New South Wales. Woo! They have 4 points.
You barracking for the red team? Hope so.
Right, now, let's talk about our next game. We get a guy and a gal, we tie them together, we blindfold them, we put them in a sack, and then we get them to roll along a course. It's all part of tumbling tumbleweeds. That's all we really ask them to do.
Oh, plus we ask them to knock down all the cactuses on the way. The game's played in 2 heats and a final, and in the first heat we have the 2 New South Wales teams, so it's red up against yellow, and here's our ref in black and white, Ricky May.
I'll keep rolling along.
So away they go. We have the guy and the gal inside that sack, and they also have a caller who can assist them along the track, because otherwise they're going to be in all sorts of trouble. So now the red for New South Wales. South Wales, Rod Stanmore is in there, together with Joanne Stanmore. And Michelle Fitzgerald is the caller for them. They've knocked over their first cactus.
Michelle's a PE teacher at Lumiere. She said she got practice for this, yelling at the kids.
Over.
For the Highlanders, we have Gordon Scott inside. He's a teacher at Braidwood, joined by his wife, Judy, who's also a teacher. She does PE. And the caller, Donata Page, doing a great job.
Well, they're going particularly well. They've knocked over three. They're coming up to number four. Once they get there, they have to go up.
Ooh.
Down they go. They have to roll through that little pool there. Then they go over the finishing line. And wowee, what a big finish from that group. Rolling home, rolling home.
That was good.
Won it pretty easily. Any problems, Ricky?
Any problems? We've still got one down the track, but yes, it's a win for Yellows, Billy.
Oh, no, so the Yellows make it very nicely into the final. Heat number two is on its way. We have the Blues and the Greens, and here's Ricky.
Here on the range I belong.
Right, oh, here they go. It's the Blue of Victoria against the Green of South Australia.
And in Green for South Australia, inside the sack, wandering around the ground there. At the moment we have Noel Kennedy, who's a research engineer, plays squash. Diane McDonald, who is the secretary for a department store. And their caller is Wendy Orchard, who's a hairdresser.
Righto. Tell you about the Blues. Underneath there is Gordon Sanger. He's a bricklayer. We have Mary Wilson in there also. She's studying accountancy. And Sue Lemke is a policewoman. She's the caller for them.
She said she's used to this directing traffic. Gives her great practice for this kind of yelling.
Now, the Greens have missed one. They've got to come back a bit here.
They have to.
Missed one back behind them. They've knocked over two, but they've got to come back and get number one. Here's the Blues having all sorts of trouble trying to knock theirs over. Back they come. They've done it this time. Yes, they have.
That was a bit of a back kick to get that one done.
It certainly was. Now, the Blues lining up for their next one, but it'll be the Greens ahead. They've knocked over three as opposed to the two of the Blues, who are going right out of bounds just about.
The Blues are everywhere. If this was an intersection, we'd be in terrible trouble if Sue was directing.
Greens have number four over, so they have to run through that.
There they go.
And then they cross that finishing line up there. But that's not as easy as it sounds, but they've done it pretty well.
Wendy Orchard directing traffic there.
Over the line.
Looks like they've done it.
Righto, Ricky, any problems?
Well, only some problems for our other team, but marvellous for the Green. They were behind and they came back and won. Good on them. Good.
They are there.
So, let's have our final find out who's going to get the points, Yellow or Green. Ricky.
Drifting along with the final.
Away they go in the Green. Here we have Noel Kennedy under there and Diane McDonald, and their caller is Wendy Orchard.
And in the Yellow we have Gordon Scott, the teacher from Braidwood, his wife Judy Scott, who's a PE teacher, as I said before, and their caller, Donata Page.
Yellow's having a bit of trouble here at the moment. They're under now though. Greens have knocked over one, they're on to number two.
Wendy Orchard, the hairdresser, proved to be a good caller before. Maybe she can do it again.
Making their way up to number three, which they've done. Done very successfully, but the Yellow coming home pretty strongly. Whoop, they've gone straight past it. Green having a bit of trouble finding number four.
Donata Page.
They have got it.
All they've got's the water.
Whoop. Now they're coming up to that water. They've missed the water totally. They're well off course. Themselves into it, but they've missed out. They've got to roll right back down. Big time, the Yellows are a little bit lost over there too. They're going back to knock it over. Can they do it?
They've not.
No, they've just missed it too.
Still going
about it. Back they go.
Yes,
now they're going to come through for the Green Maker. They go through the water. Rushing towards the line and they're home.
Yes,
they are. Well, the Greens seem to get lost there for a while, Ricky.
What a great final. Of course, it's a Green win. Hard luck, Yellow.
All right, the Green of South Australia get the 4 points. Let's see if Fiona can find someone in there.
All right.
I've got, they're in the sack. I'm just trying to get them out. How are you going in there?
Not too bad.
Oh, that was wonderful. That was great calling, Wendy.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, well, I'll let you have a break. You've won 4 points.
I will do first up is at the two there for the Yellows. They're their first points of the night, so up they go. Two for the Yellow and four for the Green over there. So they hit the front. Okay, the guys get the shakes in Bottle Babies. It's more fun and excitement for you. We'll be back with it just after the break right here on It's a Knockout.
It's a Knockout. That's the name of the game.
Here we go. Well, Victoria and the Blue yet to open their accounts. On two, we have the Highlanders. On four, we have the Shearers. And And our leaders from South Australia, doing it fairly well out there with 6 points, are the Ramblers.
Oh, we might have another South Australian winner. You never know.
Oh, yeah. Ooh.
In the next game, it's a knockout. Babies have to learn to fill their own bottles. And the girls are hindering their progress across a plank by shaking it like crazy.
All right, we have 4 babies in each team.
Right.
Time limit is 1.5 minutes. The 4 points will go to the team that can get the most liquid in that bottle in the time limit, or can fill it up in the fastest possible time.
Let's see what happens.
We have the Blues all set to go. Thanks, Rick.
Da 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 goo goo.
Oh, nice one, Ricky. Little goo goo. Time limit, as I said, 1.5 minutes, so away they go.
That was Peter Bug who went across then, a salesman who does a bit of motorcycling.
Next up is Peter Alexander. Bit of a shot. Oh, just near the end.
Oh. He went in. Gordon Sanger next. He's a bricklayer. He'd be used to being on scaffolding. Love the bear on his bottom.
By the way, the opposition is coming from the Highlanders. Patricia Young and Di Ellerton are the two girls who are giving them the big shake-up.
Here comes Ray Bennett. Very big safety pants on his nappy there. He's a cleaning contractor.
He did it pretty well, too.
He
they
did.
Have just 50 seconds to go.
They're getting quite a bit of water in
there.
A
bit of trouble. Of concentration too.
Yeah, it was.
Did it well. Coming up to our final 10 seconds of
one
this
level.
Particular event.
One level going up quite strongly for
they
the
are
team.
Getting it in there quite well. Can he make it? Yes, he can.
Yeah,
can he get it in there?
Yeah.
That's the thing. Oh, ran into a bit of trouble there. Can't put any more in after that Hooter sounds. Let's get a reading over there with referee Rick.
It's 28. You wouldn't want to be a ref for this game, do I tell you?
Let's go.
28. Here's the end of New South Wales, all set to go, and here is Ricky. Right, oh, there they go. First up here is Robert Jackson for the Highlanders.
He's a truck driver.
He didn't last long either.
Brad Hewitt wearing the yellow bear in the water.
The level I have to beat is 28, standing at the credit of the Blues at the moment.
Bruce Stewart going across there in a pair of frilly knickers. He's a builder. Wayne Fanning next up, the maths teacher. He's got a bear on his nappy. Yes, the bear got him safely across.
And the opposition comes from the Blues, by the way, the Warriors, Sue Astelik and also Leslie Rushmer.
Here comes Brad Hewitt again, stock and station agent. Oh, so close.
50 seconds remaining for this team. They want to get a bit of a shuffle on if they're going to get that 28.
They will. Bruce Stewart carrying a bit of water in his nappy as well as in his bucket.
Doesn't look particularly glamorous, does it?
No, and there's Wayne Fanning dry, the maths teacher.
Wayne did it while he scooted across there.
They're topping up the water bottle now. Oh!
No, 30 seconds.
So frustrating, yet so close.
They'll need a bit of a finish here, these boys, if they're going to knock off the greens. Or the Blues, rather.
Water going in. Couple more buckets of water will do it.
Well, then.
But they're getting close to time.
15 seconds to go.
There goes the bear.
Oh, quick one. Very well done. Hey, they're building up well. This could be a tight one.
Less.
Could be a big finish. Big finish, yes. They have done well. There's the Hooter. Ricky chops them off. And let's see how they came. They came out pretty strongly. What did they finish up with, Rick?
Well, they finished up with a wet referee and 35 points.
Wow! 35 is brilliant. South Australia beat it. Ricky, let's find out.
Total beat is 35 in action right now. The Greens of South Australia. These are the Ramblers. Remember, 90 seconds.
And number one across that plank, Graham Mofflin, who's a transport man. Does a bit of water skiing.
Next up is David Nancaro.
He's a policeman. Oh, he just made it. Oh, dear me.
By the way, the opposition are the Reds. They're the Shearers. The two girls are Leonie Clay and Joanne Stanmore.
And it's a very chilly night, by the way, so those nappies wouldn't be too warm. They'll be thinking about that as well.
He's right. He just made it.
Colin Gifford, who's a salesman, who's done a bit of surfing. That might help. And Mick Madigan, looking absolutely sensational in a frilly knicker. He's the smart merchant.
Well, he's
too. All his friends are going to be looking at him now.
having a bit of a giggle, I'd say. Remember, that total beat is 35.
And we're coming in. Water in there.
We're coming in at this time. Just 40 seconds remaining.
They might just do it.
Hey, they're going along pretty well.
They're doing well.
As they approach their final 30 seconds.
Colin Gifford coming up now. Oh, very well.
Hang on, stay with it, boy.
After this game.
They certainly are working overtime at the moment.
Bit of a wait till they get their next victim, and here he comes. Time's running up, 15 seconds left. They're approaching the 30 mark. They might just do it, Billy.
He's there. Well done.
South Australia.
He'll get this last little bit in.
4 seconds, less.
Yeah, hey, big finish. There's the winner. Hey, they come home strongly again. What have we got over there, Ricky?
Wasn't that a come home strong? It's 41.
No! Team coming up for the New South Wales Shearers in the red, and here's Ricky May. All right, he's got them on their way. The total for them to beat this time round, it is 41. That stands to the credit of the Ramblers, and that's not the best of starts.
That was Don Party, the long, lean baby who just went in there. He's a teacher for Lumiere School.
A reminder once again, the time limit is 1 minute and 30 seconds.
Followed by Rob Stanmore. Rod's a production engineer.
He's okay. He got caught up a little bit, but he's right.
Here comes Gordon Bray. He's a chimney sweep from Camden. And yes, he made it. Good work.
First one to get home for them, too.
And
just made
a full
it.
Bucket. Last but not least, Brian Clay. Oh, and he's leaping across there. He's a truck driver.
Opposition this time round will be coming from the Greens of South Australia, the Ramblers. The two girls here doing the job are Heather Dwyer.
Oh, gosh.
Wow.
Don't he's party.
He's out of here.
Anyway, in a big way.
Oh, yes.
Rod Stanmore, the production engineer.
35 seconds to go. Can they make it? Remember, the total of meters 41.
Less than 15 points in there.
Oh, stay with it, boy. Stay with it.
I'm so glad this thing's padded.
Get that next one.
Brian Clay coming across it out. Oh.
What a rocky old ride towards the end there, but home.
Good work from the opposition team, ladies.
So here we are into the final 10 seconds. Big finish required from here. Ooh, will they get it in time? There goes the hood up. Right, time is up. Ricky, how do we go?
Right on 26 for us. It's a funny game.
26 is not enough. Our winners this time round are the green team. Here's Fiona.
What a bunny bunch of babies, eh? That was great.
Oh, we're really pleased to get the points.
Okay, well, you did it. South Australia. Billy, how's our board looking?
Well, I tell you what I'll do. I'll put two up there for the yellows. So there they go. And we'll put up four this time for the greens. They really hit the front. We ask the teams to walk the beach ball next. They have to have skill. They have to have balance. You'll see all about it when we return right here on It's a Knockout.
It's a Knockout. That's the name of the game.
Good night, so we might have a good look at that scoreboard.
Good idea.
No points on the board as yet for the Blues. Come on, team. Start up on four, we have the Reds and the Yellows. That's the Shearers of the Highlanders and our runaway leaders at the moment are the Greens of South Australia. The Ramblers are there on 10 points.
Oh, you're barracking for the Green team. Good work.
Just before we have our next event, we might have a chat to the teams, eh?
All right, seeing it's middle ground, let's have a see how they're feeling.
All right, here's Terry Gainey over here from the Shearers. Terry, 4 points, all right?
Oh, not too bad. We'll get better.
Can you handle this one?
I think so.
All right. All the best. I hope you can. Righto.
Okay, Peter, Victoria.
Put them up now for 4 points and we'll give it 110%.
You think you can do it?
Sure can.
Okay, give it a try.
Our next team are the Highlanders over here from New South Wales. Bernie Basibi. Bernie, 4 points.
Easy 4 points. We have a lot of big balls in Braidwood, so we should do well.
Righto, give it to them, my boy.
And South Australia are definitely smiling. Noel, how have you been doing it?
It's just hard work, I guess. It's been fantastic.
Okay, well, good luck with this one. I hope you pick up another few points.
We might start the ball rolling right now with Ricky May.
On your beat.
Hooray! And away they go. Okay, let's tell you about those teams, shall we?
In the red for New South Wales, the Shearers, we have Don Party, Terry Gainey and Dave Wilson, who likes a bit of golf, doing the running.
And first of the girls up there is Carolyn Knight.
That's right. And for the blue team beside them, Gordon Sanger, who likes indoor cricket, Ray Bennett helping out, Peter Buck, who's a motorcyclist.
Over there for the Highlanders, we have, let's see now Brad Hewitt, Robert Jackson and Bernie Basivi. And their first girl on board is Donata Page. She's a life-saving instructor. Might come in handy herself here, I think.
Oh, it must be Victoria's down there. The object of this game is the girls have to try and stay on top of that beach ball while the guys roll it along. Obviously, if they can go fairly fast, it works well. For the Ramblers for South Australia, we have Scott Galloway, who likes a bit of gym, Noel Kennedy, the golfer, Colin Gifford, who likes darts, of all things, and the girl up on top there is Carmel Tooth, who's a bank clerk.
So they have to get the two girls down to the far end of that pontoon and have them deposited there to get the 4 points for first.
Poor old Sue Lemke, the policewoman for Victoria, has fallen down twice with the blue team, but she's doing quite well, actually.
Blue just in advance of the yellows at the moment, but the other two teams are so close, it just doesn't matter.
Oh, Donata's come off the court for New South Wales in yellow.
So that leaves the Blues out there in the lead. But they've also lost their little passenger up there, Sue Lemke.
They still have another passenger to pick up, mind you. This isn't the end now.
Yes, they deposit this particular girl at pontoon and then away they go.
Look at Victoria go. They know they need those points and they're out to get them.
So it's the Blues just ahead of the yellow at the moment. Red about to come in. And finally the Reds of South Australia will deposit their young lady, which is Carmel too.
Good run now to New South Wales in red. And there goes South Australia.
So as we get back to the other end, the Reds will pick up Michelle Fitzgerald. The Blues will pick up Mary Wilson. The Yellows pick up Judy Scott. And for the Ramblers, the next passenger is Diane McDonald.
She's a secretary. Okay, here comes the Highlanders. The yellow team doing quite well. The girls told me that they have to try and move, stay forward on the ball, even though it feels terribly insecure.
Well, the Blues are having a bit of trouble. They were the first ones back there, but the Reds don't seem to be making much headway at the moment. Matter of fact, it's the Reds have gone to a narrow lead.
It's coordination here. If the girls keep moving faster, the guys have to move that ball faster too.
So this could be a photo finish. I hope you're ready here, Ricky.
It's bottoms up and the girls are heading down the track.
A battle royal here as we walk the beach ball. It's the Reds just... Oh, no, the Yellows might have got to the front now. Yes, Yellows of New South Wales coming through. Red not far behind. Green of South Australia in third. They've recovered well.
Victoria doing quite slowly on this one, though.
Oh, yeah, look as though they've had a flat tyre, I think. Something's going very slowly. But a big battle here between the Yellows and the Reds as they come down for the 4 points. Green also from South Australia coming through strongly.
Yellow lost a bit of ground then. Yeah. Oh, they're falling. Oh, dear.
So it's settled down as a battle between the Greens and the Reds. Can the Reds get another four over the Greens? Really consolidate themselves at the top of the ladder here. Green now out in front. Gee, they've recovered very well, the South Australians.
Checking out the position. They know they haven't got far to go.
I don't blame them having a look over their shoulder.
Looks
and
like
now the two girls on the pontoon. Green coming home. The green machine is revving up to the task again.
Red coming in strongly there too.
The Blues have really dropped out of it over there.
And they're close. Here they are.
We have a green time. Greens are there. Now the battle for second spot. Let's have a look at them. Yellow and red doing it here. Here they come.
Second for Red. I'm not sure the Yellows and Blues still coming in.
I tell you what, the Greens have done it very well. They're all
killing it back
there. Here they are over there with Fiona.
So, girls, have you got any skin left on your knees? Excuse me, they're so excited about winning. Have you got any skin on your knees left?
A little bit.
Hey, what about you? Any on your hands?
Well, they're a bit rough now.
Just a little bit. Okay, great teamwork. 4 points for you. Kelly, what's the team position on the scoreboard?
Well, what I'll do first up is put the two there for New South Wales, take them to six, and another four for South Australia. Well, the arena is set for the chariot race. Join us and our live audience after the break right here for It's a Knockout.
It's a Knockout, that's the name of the game.
For us right now, and I still cannot get any points up there for the Blues.
We're trying.
Six for New South Wales, that's in the Reds. We have four over there for the Yellows. And 14, South Australia are really going great guns at the moment.
South Australia are doing brilliantly.
Fantastic.
Okay, next up we have chariot race, back to ancient times. And this time the teams are relying on the girls, both for their driving and for their running repairs.
Yeah, that wheel keeps falling off, so it makes a bit of a stop and start effort. Two heats and a final, 4 points for the winner, two for the runner-up. Here's heat number one, it's the Blues against the Yellows. And here's a Ricky.
All roads lead.
Oh, there they go. So what you see here is the girls going down to pick up the wheel, they put it on the chariot, and then back they go, and two laps of the course is all they have to do. Simple, isn't it?
It's simple. It's a bit hard for the guys because they have to provide the horsepower. Two guys under there make up the horses, and for our teams in the yellow, we have Bernie Bassiv and Wayne Fanning underneath making up the horse, and Patricia Young, who's a housewife, a good driver, and she's in charge of the chariot.
Over there with the blues, it's Nigel Starr and Roger Hall underneath. We haven't lost a wheel as yet. And the girl, Leslie Rushmer there, will have to get out and put that wheel back on. Meanwhile, the yellows have made the turn before they last much longer.
Leslie told me she's never been booked for driving. She's got a really good record.
She's coming home pretty strongly at the moment.
Seems to me the yellow team have figured out how to keep the wheel on. They're leaning rather heavily on one side.
She's getting down there. Just made it in the nick of time. Any problems, Mr. May?
One of the great tactical wins to the colour of yellow.
Oh, yellow. Yes.
Heat two, and this time the Shearers in red come up against the Ramblers in green. Who's going to win, Ricky?
To run or not to run? This is a question.
So away they go. And the red is the Shearers from New South Wales, and it's the green, it's the Ramblers of South Australia.
And a good run down there from Heather Dwyer, who's already putting her wheel on, but Carolyn Knight for the red team isn't far behind.
Underneath there for the reds in the horse are Brian Clay and Dave Wilson.
And for the greens, David Nancaro and Graham Moffat, and they're trotting off already. What a good little runner that horse is.
Greens thundering down the way, the wheel is still on. Reds in a little bit of trouble, and they're going pretty slowly at the moment. Greens scooting out in front of the moment of the greens. That wheel staying on pretty well. Round the corner they go.
He's
coming the corner a little bit there too, is that our red boy?
Oh, the green team lost the wheel.
So are the reds,
double uh-oh. Green team have their wheel back on again.
Wheel is back on, back into the chariot.
Oh, and running.
Down the line. And there
it is.
All right, Ricky, any problems?
No. Hello, Alan. Keep going. You'll be there in a minute. No, it's a win, as you can see, for green. Nice going, Red. You probably don't remember us.
Another final. We are moving into our final. Can the yellows halt the progress of the greens? Ricky, help us find out.
All right, the girls are ready. Good luck, girls. Go!
The green of the Ramblers, of course, from South Australia. They're going really well here tonight, and their competition is coming in this time from the yellows, the Highlanders from New South Wales.
All South Australia in the green. That's Heather Dwyer. She's just getting aboard. And this horse with the stylish leg action is David Nancaro and Graham Moffat.
Over there for the yellows, it's Bernie Bassiv and Wayne Fanning of the horse. And they've
got the wheel.
Patricia Young's over there to pick it up. They've lost them.
Oh, dear.
So the greens have the yellows starting to catch up a little bit now. Greens having trouble with the wheel.
Oh, dear. Patricia Young steering a good horse around there.
Yellows going into the turn. The greens can't get the wheel back on. Yellows cutting that corner a little bit. Now round they go. Put me a collision.
Oh.
Back up the yellows now.
Racing
down the
track.
Course. Can they get the major points? They're looking pretty good. Can the wheel hang on? Greens have lost theirs. Oh, and yellow.
What a
yellow. Wow, Ricky.
Oh, that was a good match.
It wasn't a mellow. Yellow was a pretty solid one.
It was a solid win for yellow. Good luck, yellow.
All right, here's Fiona with them now. Something a little bit different. I can only add two this time for the greens, but that's enough for them to go to 16. And I put another four out there for the yellows. They go into second spot at eight. Well, the shark warnings are out for our swimmers next time round. It's Hammerhead. That is our next game for you, and we'll bring it to you right after the break.
It as follows.
What are we going to do with the blues?
I don't know. you're going to have to cheer louder, Blues supporters.
No points for them as yet. We have six up there for the Reds, the Shearers. The Highlanders moving along quite nicely into second spot on eight, but still our leaders and pretty strong leaders are the Ramblers of South Australia. They're on 16.
They're doing well.
Now, you've heard the story before. Just when our teams thought it was safe to go back into the water, we've come up with
it's
some pretty
never
vicious,
safe in the water.
We've come up with some vicious sharks in Hammerhead.
That's right. Two skin divers in full gear have to run the gauntlet in an attempt to reach their team mermaid and pin stars onto her tail.
Oh, wow.
It's an individual event with a time limit of 45 seconds, and first up to face the man-eaters are the Highlanders. So, Ricky, set them running.
Right, here we go. 45 seconds is the time limit.
The divers are Bruce Stewart and Bernie Bassiff. They have to run down there, the mermaid pin the stars under a tail, and then get back again without falling into the water.
The mermaid, by the way, is Judy Scott, and the opposition there from the Ramblers is that massive mermaid. Graham Moffat is the man inside there.
The guys are picking up a couple more stars from the star reserve at the end. Now they have to face the shark. Oh, yes!
Oh, yeah!
Oh, he made it!
I will take care of him.
Oh, he has to put that star back on the mermaid's bottom. It fell off.
10 seconds to go. Where they do fall off. He attacked the shark.
The shark's probably wondering what was happening. There's another star. Oh, it's fallen off.
Time is up. Ricky, what did you do for us there, mate?
Well, the shark has nailed four.
Four. That's a good one.
Good one. Next up, the winning team, the Ramblers from South Australia. Ricky.
Mermaid ready. Shark steady.
And in action for the Greens, we have Mick Manigan and Noel Kennedy.
And their mermaid is Wendy Orchard. She's a hairdresser and she's waiting for the stars down there.
The opposition shark is from the Highlanders, and that is Robert Jackson. The
one.
Total.
Go on, one star on the bottom.
The total of it is four.
All right, there's two. And there's a diver in the water.
Having trouble getting back, too.
Oh.
20 seconds remaining. Boys, I want to get a little bit of move on.
Here comes another star.
Getting back to
waiting.
No, shark's taking care of it.
Just the thought of the shark was enough. Only 10 seconds to go.
Boys having trouble staying on board here. The shark moves up to the kill again.
The shark's just going for one diver there. It's a bit one-sided. Oh, time's up.
Ah, I don't think we had enough there. How many did we have, Ricky?
Well, they finished with three. Very, very talented shark, Bill.
Oh, not quite good enough, though. Here is heat number three, and it's the Reds from New South Wales, and Ricky lets them rip.
Hold a shot.
Total meet is four. That stands to the credit of the Yellows at the moment, the Highlanders.
Oh, two red team divers in the water already. Gordon Bray, who's a chimney sweep, and Rod Stanmore, production engineer. They're the divers for this team for New South Wales.
Their mermaid up there is Leonie Clay. The boys have started pretty well.
Leonie's a travel consultant.
And the opposition hammerhead shark is Nigel Starr.
In the water. In the water, out of the water. It doesn't matter as long as they get more stars in the first team.
Time limit is 45 seconds. The boys are on the way back. Can they level it up here?
Here they go.
Oh, few more, they've leveled it up.
Yes, it's four. Oh, four stars there.
Hammerhead's trying to take it. Oh, it's a good one. How'd it go, Ricky?
Yeah, it's four.
Got it all tied up.
So can the Warriors beat that score of four? Let's find out, Ricky.
Dun, 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 dun.
Two teams up there, the Highlanders and also the Shearers, have the 4 points at the moment. Trying to do something about it for the Warriors. We have Gordon Sanger and also Peter Bug.
Peter Bug, now these guys desperately need points. They have none at all on the board at the moment. None on the board at the moment. And their mermaid is Leslie Rushmer.
The opposition shark is from the Shearers, and that is Terry Gainey underneath there.
Terry's going to be trying really hard to stop them because... Oh!
15 seconds to go.
No!
Oh, sharks scored well.
Not long to go now. Gonna have to hurry. There's another star on the bottom.
On the way, on the way. Whoa!
Oh.
Okay. What have we got over there, Ricky?
Well, the shark got the better of Victoria and the Blues that time. Only three fish.
Uh-oh, only three. That means we have a tie this time round. It's the Yellows and also the Reds have tied it up with four. And they're both over there with Fiona.
So you both have to share the points. Do you mind?
No.
Okay, that was great. Mermaids don't mind. No one minds. Billy, let's put the points up on the board. See how it looks.
We three for the Yellows, and we'll have three for the Reds, and that's how they go up there. All right, shaping up pretty well. Train race is one of the very chaotic events we have for you. It's a good one to finish up, so I hope you'll join us after the break when we return right here on It's a Knockout.
It's a Knockout, that's the name of the game.
Quickly have a look at the points. The Blues, this is their last chance. Nine up there for the Reds. We have 11 for the Yellows and 16 for the Blues.
Okay, the last chance to score. This is the great train race. And here's the chief of Boogie, Ricky May.
Oh, what a great start. Okay, here's what happens. They pedal their way downfield. They just push along the top of the wheel. It might look pretty simple, but it's not really.
It's actually very hard work.
The girl gets out halfway down in her suitcase. She has some clothes. She has to change into those. The boys continue, pick up two milk cartons at the end, come back and pick the girl up. She's got to be fully dressed. They come back and they all have to get back onto the pontoon at the end. Simple, simple.
Quite a complicated train race, I think. Okay, let's have a look at our teams. In the red, we have Don Pardy and Terry Guinea from Fairvale High. They're the guys.
And Michelle Fitzgerald is the young lady there.
For the Warriors, we have Nigel Starr and Roger Hall.
Sue Lemke is the young lady.
The yellow team. Bruce Stewart and Gordon Scott.
Di Ellison is up there.
And in green for South Australia, David Nancaro and Scott Galway are the
and
halfway.
And Diane McDonald is also on board, about to get changed right now.
Okay, all the girls are getting changed at this moment.
So it's the Reds about to get down there first, closely followed by the green. Blue running last. Oh, goodness.
Oh, dear.
Come on, boys, get a move on. Now the girls have to be fully dressed before they get back into the train.
And it's quite a complicated outfit they're putting on. They've got a skirt, they've got petticoats, they've got gloves, they've got all sorts of things. A little parasol, you'll see as they go.
Well, the Reds have picked up their two milk urns. They're on the way back. The Greens aren't far behind them. Yellow's pulling up and the Blues have just made it to about to load up.
Green train coming up there as well for South Australia as if they needed more points.
Well, the Reds here, if they can get a bit of a shuffle on, they could move into second spot. That's the big one for them.
Yellow team, they need these points. They're coming up behind.
So it's still red just in front of the Greens of South Australia.
And the girls are getting dressed there. Looks like everybody's managing their outfits.
There's clothes and things everywhere. It looks to me as if Michelle Fitzgerald's ready to go for the Reds. She has the umbrella up and Scott Miller.
I think she's the only one who has at this stage.
She's about to jump. Yes, she's away. And look at the Reds come home. Here are the Reds, they have their eye on that second spot. They have to unload the two milk urns. Reds looking pretty good though. Both around, the milk urns are coming around. Both of them have to be back there.
One down, one to go. Green have just touched home. Now maybe they can rush down with the milk urns.
Back they go.
What a great winner.
All right, so it's official placing there. Red will be first, green will be second. Means that the Reds go up to 13. That'll put them in the second spot. And the Greens are winners tonight. They're on 18.
And again, South Australia. Next week we have a $2,000 quarterfinal featuring those high scorers, the Coorong Castaways from South Australia.
All right, that's about it for tonight. See you, Rick.
See you.
See you, folks. We'll see you next week. Once again, Hugh Fletcher.
The update of the Eyewitness News is next, and a movie about one of the men involved in the Watergate scandal in Washington follows. It's the story of G. Gordon Liddy. And more news, the Thornbirds is coming back to 10. Once was certainly not enough.
This is a Grundy television production in association with Network 10 Australia. Max Rowley speaking.